Thank you guys for tuning back into another video. We have another 2024. This is a Honda CR-V EX Platinum White Pearl with the gray interior. This model is all-wheel drive. In my opinion, this is a important trim level too, because it's one above the LX, which is the base model, and you have the EXL above this, the Sport Hybrid, Sport L, Sport Touring. So there's a lot of trim levels above this one, but just in case you don't want a hybrid and you don't want a fully loaded gas model, you have the EX. So for 23, the CR-V has been completely redesigned. You can see new headlights, full LED high beam, low beam, turn signals, daytime running lights. There is no fog lights. I've heard that these headlights are bright enough that you don't need fog lights anymore. I don't know if that's true or not, but you don't have no fog lights on here. Bumper does have a little aerodynamic curtain in there. You have flat black on the lower portion of the bumper, gloss black on the grille, Honda emblem with your radar, big H up front. You do have a chrome piece right above the grille and through the headlights. You do have the longer hood, so give you like that roadster type design, wider windshield, updated camera for the Honda sensing, and you do get a moonroof on the EX as well, because the LX, you don't get a moonroof. In my opinion, this is a big jump from the LX. Biggest thing is no hubcaps that the LX gives you. You do have alloy wheels on here. And equipment wise, you just get a lot more for the money versus an LX. But if you want a little bit more, you like the plain Jane, just want a little bit more, want some creature comforts, this is the trim level to go with. So on the wheels here, I believe these are 18s, if I'm not mistaken. So these are 235, 60, 18s, correct? You have a little flat black right above it. And then you do have a little flat black right down the sides as well. And then you have an integrated turn signals right here. So on the side mirrors, you have LED turn signals integrated, body color on the top of the mirror, flat black on the lower portion of the mirror. And then coming around the windows, you can see a chrome all the way around top and bottom. And the EX will give you the privacy tint from Honda. If you get an LX, this whole thing, you can see in there pretty much. It'll be pretty much like the fronts. The rears are a privacy tint. The fronts are non-privacy tint, but all the windows are still tinted, so it will help protect your interior from the sun and your skin as well. Taking a look at the rear, you have this signature CR-V taillights that climbs up the rear pillar. They are LED, but the turn signals are regular bulbs. Reverse lights are LED, so it's a combination. You do have the exposed windshield wiper. You have a window spoiler that's half body colored and half flat black. Your antenna is a shark fin style and it's body colored as well. And the platinum white pearl is a very, I'll say, popular color. This one is dirty and you can't even barely tell. That's one reason why everyone loves this color. Also in the sun, I have no sun right now, but you can see the pearl kind of shine in the sun. It's a beautiful color, I like it very much. Coming down to the lower portion here, flat black on the lower portion, no exposed exhaust. But because you have the turbo 1.5 four-cylinder, you do have dual exhaust underneath, all-wheel drive badge here, and the Honda emblem is in chrome, CR-V's in chrome, no EX badge on the back. And coming around to the side here, you do have a capless fuel filler. It's what Honda call it, so there's no gas cap. Good to go. Technically, this is your cap here. And when you lock the CR-V, it locks this door. Taking a look at the key, so this is the new Honda key design that's on everything now. The EX will give you remote start built in on the key. You have lock, unlock. You don't have a power trunk, it's a manual trunk, but if you get an EXL, then you can get the power trunk. And you have your panic button as well. And you do have emergency key on the inside, so if you pull this tab and pull up, there's a key inside the fob itself. And there is a keyhole right underneath this guy as well. I don't know if I can do this without opening. There you go. You have the keyhole right there. But because you have the smart key, you have smart entry. So if you tap these three lines right there, locks all the doors. If you put your hand in there without pulling it, unlock all the doors. Now by default, the driver door is the only door that unlocks when you put your hand on the driver door. If you go to the passenger's door, it unlocks all four doors. You can also come up to the trunk when the CR-V is locked and push the button there and it'll unlock for you as well. But you can go into menus and change it if you want it to be all doors unlocked when you put your hand in the driver's door. EX will come standard with blind spot monitoring. I know on the 23s, I made a few videos saying CR-Vs were coming in with blind spot, some without it. I've been noticing that most of the 24s have been coming in with blind spot. So I wonder if Honda fixed the chip shortage issue that he had. Not too sure. But unlock, open it up. This one is the gray interior. So gray is a little bit different this year, well, this generation, than the 22s. So usually if you had an EX and it was gray, beige, or black interior, the whole seat will be one color. But if you get an EXL and get gray interior, the whole seat, the whole leather seat will be gray. But if you get gray, like in a hybrid, like a sport hybrid, or actually sport touring is the only hybrid that can get a light interior color. If you get a sport L or a sport, it's only black. So if you get a sport touring in gray, it will be leather, but gray in the middle, black on the outside. So interesting take that Honda went with the newer generation, especially if you want gray interior, because a lot of people will see gray interior and thinks that the whole seat is gray, but it's still black on the outside as well. But the start on the door here, it is a soft touch here, and take this guy off. Soft touch and is leather wrap. Not sure if this is real leather or not, but it's soft. Top of the door is soft as well. And you don't really have much of a design here. You have this little piece right here, which is, it's not gloss black, so it's actually pretty nice. You get the aluminum look to the door handle. Power windows, auto up down for the driver and passenger. And you have the whole lid for the rear. If you get an EXL and up, then all four windows are auto up and down. Power locks, power mirrors, super simple. Storage down here, cup holder or water bottle, you can throw in there as well. The driver's seat is power. So you have in and out for your lumbar support, forward and back for your back, forward and back for the whole seat, and up and down for this portion of the seat. On the passenger seat on the EX, it's manual, so you have the bar to pull forward and back. This will adjust your back, and that's it. There's no up and down. Let's take a seat. Let's get in here. Always get that chime when you close the door. It's push button start on every CRV. You just won't get the smart entry. Oh, turn that down. You just won't get the smart entry on every trim level. I think LX is the only one to not get the smart entry. But take a look here. Every CRV will have the same cluster here. So it's a half digital, half analog layout where the right side is a speedometer. So the traditional needle, and that's it. Left side is customizable. You can view all types of information that you wanted to. Your left stock over here will have off, auto, parking, and on, and you also have auto high beams. On the right stock is your windshield wipers. So you have off, intermediate, low, high for the front, and then you have off, intermediate, and on for the rear wiper back there. And coming along down here, you have next track, previous, volume, source. You have voice command or voice control, and you have your home button here that controls that screen there. And I've went over the screen pretty much on every Honda. So you have your brightness control, you can have nothing showing, you can see what safety features you have on, so road departure, blind spot information, collision braking, and then let's go back, you have your oil life, we got your seat belts on, which is cool, all-wheel drive torque, are you awake enough to drive, the engine's speed and time, range and fuel is probably what everyone usually use, you have warning, gauge settings, and brightness as well, so I'll just leave it on range and fuel. So we'll get back here. And a lot of people have been messaging me about the average fuel. When these cars first come in, you know, they're here on the lot. I try to jump in them and make a video on them. So the average fuel on these are not accurate because it's not from someone owning the car for a few days or anything like that. So keep that in mind. On the right side of the steering wheel, you do have your cruise control on and off, cancel, resume, set. You have your lane keep assist button here, adaptive cruise control button here. And the steering wheel itself is made out of like the polyurethane material. If you want leather, you have to get EXL and up. But this is the same material at like the LX. So you have some, the same like kind of material on the door handle right here in the middle. I actually like this. If you get anything higher than this, this piece right here is gloss black, but I actually like the gray. On the left side here, all you have the traction control on and off button there. And then you have the lever to open and pop the hood. Open and close the hood. Pop the hood as well. So you got that. Now, coming along to the center console here, you do have a different screen from EXL and up. So this is the same screen on the LX. And, oh, actually, the Sport Hybrid will have the same screen too. So this is a 7-inch touchscreen display. And if you go ending above the Sport Hybrid, then you get the 9-inch display. But because this is the smaller screen, you get you have to plug in your phone to use Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. If you get the bigger 9-inch display, then you get the wireless Apple CarPlay and wireless Android Auto. But the screen is still good. Like you have volume, you have a tune button, physical buttons, and a touchscreen. You have shortcuts, so you have next track, previous, phone, radio, AM, FM. You have media, so Bluetooth and USB, and Apple CarPlay, Android Auto when your phone is plugged in, and your menu button. So real simple, easy to use. Put in reverse, you can see the backup camera. No 360, but you have a multi-angle backup camera, so wide angle, normal, and looking straight down as well. And you have your cross traffic on and off. When that's on, it'll alert you if there's a car coming from that way or a car coming from that way, and it'll show you on the screen where it is too. It's actually pretty cool. You do get the new vent design that started on the Civic, because the CR-V is based on the Civic, so in here it's very familiar to the Civic, and you get the mesh that goes all the way across, and then you get the, I guess, the same material that's on the door right there as well. And on your climate control, you have heated seats. So even though it's cloth, they're still heated. Three different levels, high, medium, low, high, medium, low, and dual zone climate control that you don't get in the LX as well. So driver and passenger can have split different temperatures and fan speed, mode. You do have auto climate control, which is cool. Air circulation, if you want to reuse air from outside or reuse air in here. Heated defroster. You have heated side mirrors and heated rear back glass, AC on and off. Simple, easy to use. Down here for your connections, you have a combination. So you have USB-C and USB-A. This is what you use for Apple CarPlay. USB-C is just for charging. Power outlet there that no one's probably going to use. You do have some storage here. Actually, it's a lot bigger than the 22 CR-V. And you have the same material, the steering wheel on the shift knob. But your transmission mode, you have park, reverse, neutral, drive, of course. And then you have a sport mode for the transmission and a low mode for the transmission. And you have drive modes too. So you can, let me zoom in there for you guys. You have normal, you have, missing the button, normal, econ, and snow. You can put the CR-V in, which is cool. And auto stop for the engine, off button. You have an auto downhill cruise control and electronic parking brake. And you have a brake hold feature that while you're in drive, you can take your foot off the brake, it'll hold your brake. Coming along down here, you do have cup holders, and pretty universal, can fit different sizes. Little storage here. The armrest here, like this middle piece is always like super soft. And then you have your storage in there. It's a lot bigger than the previous CR-V, but there's no plugins in there at all. And then you do have a lockable glove box and standard size glove box as well. Nothing too crazy. And come along up here, so you don't have no auto dimming rear view mirror. It's just a normal manual rear view mirror. And you do have a moonroof though on the EX. It starts, moonroof starts on the EX. So every trim level has a moonroof but the LX. But super nice there. And then you have your control here for the moonroof. You have LED lighting throughout the whole cabin. Sunglass holder up here. And then let's see for your visor. You have a mirror with, it's not an LED lighting, but at least they give you lighting. And let's jump into the rear seat. That's how wide the rear door is open. Actually, on the CR-V, the rear door is almost open 90 degrees. Pretty wide. You can see the rear doors just mimic the driver's door. So same type of design. Not as soft as the front door. And this is just hard. It's not soft at all, but you have still have storage. Not as much storage as the driver's door, but at least you have a storage for your water bottle and storage for anything else. And then we're gonna jump into here. And one thing that is new for 24 that I just discovered on, actually on the EXL video that I did, is you get USB-Cs in the rear compartment now for the non-hybrids. For 22, if you bought a hybrid, you get USB-Cs in the rear on the Sport and the Sport Touring, but the EX and the EXL didn't have no USB-Cs at all. You have to add them as an accessory. So for 24, they're standard now. And there's no option to add this as an accessory. So that means on the LX, you can't get this at all. So the LX doesn't come with USB-Cs in the back and you can't add them. But you do get air vents back here too. You can turn it on and off, which is pretty cool. You have no matte pocket behind the driver. You have one behind the passenger seating. And the half black, half gray continues on in the rear here. So you can see the outside is black and the middle is gray, but it's a very light gray. I'm gonna open the door and we're gonna take a look at the seats color in there again, because I know it's gonna be really important for you guys. It's hard to see the color in person, I mean on the computer, but we'll definitely take a look at that. But you have cup holders with armrests back here. This middle portion is black, and I love the newer seats for the CR-Vs where the hooks is just exposed. So if you have a car seat, you don't have to dig your finger in there to try to find the hooks. They're right there. And you do have lighting back here too, and it's still LED. Take a look at the front cockpit again. Very similar. Actually, this is very almost identical to the Sport Hybrid and the LX. Just a few more features you have in this though versus the LX. So let's take a look at the rear seats real fast. And I don't have that too much lighting, but you can see it's gray, but it's a light gray. It's actually a real light gray. So let's take a look at the rear. So the trunk, like I was telling you before, is not power. You have to get an EXL, you get a power, but at least the struts will help assist open the trunk. And because this is not a hybrid, you do get this load floor where you can raise it up to kind of be flush with the seats, or you can have it lower like how this one is, and you can fit a cargo tray in there. And speaking of cargo tray, this one has a protection package, so that's why you have that guy. Yours won't, it will come with carpet, and that's pretty much it. And since it's not a hybrid, you get a spare tire. So it's not a donut, but it's not a full size either. It's like in between. So these are 155 90 17s. So to kind of give you an idea. I mean, I don't think you can go too fast on this, but it's still a lot better than the tiny donut that you usually get. Get your tools back here. Close this guy up. So remember that floor can sit up higher and sit up here to be a little bit more flush. The 23 and the 24 CRVs did lose some features that the 22 has standard, because on a 22 EX, it came with the cargo cover standard that you pull here. Now you have to add as an accessory. Also, the little handle you used to use to pull to drop the seats down, that's gone. You have to kind of walk around to drop the seat. And I'm actually gonna do that because the floor is no longer flat anymore. So on the 22 CRV, when you drop the seat down, you didn't have a hump, it was more flat, but kind of give you guys a heads up that you have a hump there, so you can see how that looks just like that. But you still have tie downs, it's still spacious, it's wider, the opening is wider than the previous CRV. You still have a low load floor, so you'll still love this thing, but there's like kind of some things that you just don't have anymore. LED lighting on both sides. I actually like this better than the 22s, and you have a power outlet back here as well. And they give you a grocery hooks kind of built in, which is cool. Welcome to the Trim Walk. This is gonna show everything on CRVs. I use this all the time in most of my CRV videos. So today we're looking at the EX. So first thing first, Honda says that the EX adds to or upgrade from an LX. So you go LX, then you go EX. First thing the EX is gonna give you that the LX don't have is remote engine start with climate control. So when you use the remote start feature, it will, I believe, put your CRV up to 72 degrees. That way it's not too hot, not too cold. It'll stay on for 10 minutes. You can hit lock, hold the remote start button again. It'll add another 10 minutes on top of that. Super cool feature. I use it all the time when I'm about to show someone a CRV and it's a hot day. This month has been hot like crazy. Get to warm up the car before you get into it. Also, you get the 18-inch silver-painted alloy wheels. Remember, on the LX, you get hubcaps. A lot of people was like, what hubcaps? Oh, my God. Look, the LX got hubcaps. I don't know what to tell you guys. But if you don't want hubcaps, then you can get the EX and get some alloy wheels. And these are 235, 60, 18 all-season tires. LX will not have the blind spot information system with cross-traffic and Honda sensing feature. Okay, that's cool. Also, you get a one-touch power moonroof with tilt feature, so you can open it all the way or you can tilt up, which is cool. You get the dual zone automatic climate control. So I showed you guys in the video where driver can be at one temperature, passenger could catch on fire if they wanted to. And you do have smart entry with walkway auto lock. You do have a six speaker system, because I believe on the LX it's a four speaker system. Let's see if we can find that. I know you get, oh yeah, four speaker, 160 watt, and then you get 240 watt with six speakers. So upgrade the sound system on the EX. You also get the 3.0 USB-C charging port, front console, second row. So remember, on the LX, you get one USB-A, and I think that's it. So EX and up will get the USB-Cs in the second row, if that's important for you guys. And you do have a power driver seat. So it's a 10-way power driver seat with two-way lumbar support. On the 22, I know you're able to have a four-way lumbar support. I'm not sure why Honda went to a two-way on the 23s and 24s, but they did. And heated front seats, so that's going to be a deal breaker. Heated front seats on the EX, body color, the heated power side mirrors, and illuminated dragon front passenger vanity mirrors. So on the EX, the dual zone might be a deal breaker, moonroof, heated seats,
The blind spot monitor is just going to be a deal breaker. I know pretty soon every car is going to have that standard. A few years ago, you have to get a top of line to have a standard, but they're kind of slowly giving it to everything. But that's going to be a big deal for you guys. Remote start maybe, but let's jump in and build an EX. So here we are. Here's all the levels. And like I was telling you guys, LX, EX, and EXL is gas only, no hybrid. Sport Hybrid, Sport L, and Sport Touring are going to be a three hybrid. So you got three gas, three hybrids. Easy to choose from. It's interesting that the Sport Hybrid is lower, like price lower than the EXL, even as a hybrid, because the hybrid's supposed to be more premium. But the EXL does give you a lot more features than Sport Hybrid does. But we're looking at the EX. Let's jump in here and look at some colors. So you have the option to get two-wheel drive or all-wheel drive. The two-wheel drive is going to give you 28 city, 34 highway, 30 combined. And if you get all-wheel drive, it's $1,500 more than two-wheel drive. And you're looking at 27 city, 32 high, which is still pretty fuel efficient, which is why most people still get the all-wheel drive anyways. Even if you don't need it, people are still gonna buy it. And I don't blame them. I'll get all-wheel drive too. So let's jump in here. You have Canyon River Blue, which only comes with black cloth interior. You have the crystal black pearl. We have the option between black cloth or the gray cloth. And remember, if you get gray interior, it's gray in the middle and black on the outside. That's really important because previous CR-V was never like that. So some people that's been buying Hondas may not know that and may not like the black or the gray look. But you got that guy on the crystal black pearl, Lunar Silver. Only comes with black interior. You have the meteorite gray metallic. You have the option between the black and the gray. You have platinum white pearl, which we just looked at, which is black or gray. And you have the radiant red, which is only gray. So if you get gray, I mean, if you get red, you only get gray interior. And you have the Steelnut Pearl, which also only comes in black cloth. And you get the Urban Gray Pearl, which only comes in black cloth as well. So if you go with platinum white pearl, 55 more, or the radiant red, or the Steelnut Pearl, or the Urban Gray, is a premium price that Honda charges you. So you're gonna have that. So that guy with the gray interior, let's look at the pricing. So base price is 33,510 plus the platinum color, 455. And you do have your destination and handling, which is 1295. MSRP currently is 35,260. At the end of the year, I'm sure the MSRP may go up. Next year, it definitely may go up. I don't know, but I'm recording July 28th. Well, I recorded this a minute ago, but I'm recording this part July 28th. MSRP is 35,260, and you will get a Honda service pass that comes standard with your CR-V. So you get 2 year complimentary maintenance plan, which is free oil changes, free tire rotation, oil filters, and multi-point inspection for 2 years or 24,000 miles, which is pretty cool. So jump back into EX. We always gotta go over the accessories, and let's go with the interior. And these are the main stuff, you know. Good stuff. You can add a heated steering wheel, which is cool. You have illuminated door sill. So you cannot add a auto dimming rear view mirror. Well, actually, as well as electronic before I'm chatting. Yeah, you can't add it. You can add parking sensors front and back. You can add a wireless phone charger, but you cannot add the auto dimming rear view mirror. Not sure why. Don't forget your cargo tray. Don't come with cargo trays anymore. I know you used to 22 EXs, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Not standard anymore. But there's a lot of goodies you can add in here. Illuminated cargo sill trim. Hold on. I've never seen this before. When open the tailgate, illuminated cargo trim lights up. Oh, right here lights up. That's fire. I even know CRV. I even know CRV had this. That's fire. Made of durable polyester steel. That's fine. Okay. And also, with the pricing on here, it's going to be different per your dealership because Honda is showing you how much it's for the part by itself. They're not including shipping and handling, taxes, labor, or if it has any markup or anything like that. That's just the base price from Honda. So don't think that this is, you know, it's 185. Okay, let me go order one in my state. It may be different in your state. So give you guys a heads up. Anyways. We're going to end everything here. I hope you guys enjoyed the EX trim level walk around. I think for the money, I know the EX went up in price, but For 35, there's a lot of SUVs in this 35 price range, and a lot of them, even though you lost some little minor there are little minor features, I'll say, from the 22 to the 23 and 24, it's still a good valued vehicle. Like the way how it's packaged is actually really good because it's not too loaded, it's not too basic. You still have the turbo engine, you still have heated seats, cloth seats, moonroof, remote start. A lot of those features you have to add as a package on other cars. So it's actually pretty cool. I don't like the wheels on the EXL, but to be honest, if I'm buying something this new, I'll be fine with them. Or these are 18s as well. Let me see how those looking. I don't know, Honda, I think Honda's still tweaking their website because everything is sometimes accessories are so slow you can't even view it. But even though it's loading, I think these will look fire on the EX. But anyways, I'm at, oh, here we go. No, we go, no. All right, we know. Thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna end everything here. Stay tuned for more walk arounds. I have a playlist of CRVs. Click through the videos and check out all the trims I've done. Throughout the video, I'm gonna put links in other CRV models. So if you ever want to see all my other walk arounds on my other CRVs, you can check those out. And I do every Honda Civics, Accords, Passport, Pilot, Ridgeline, you name it. Thank you guys for watching. I'm gonna catch you guys in the next video.